the gal to begin.
One, love.
And always exciting to see two contemporaries, two teens, two stars of future present, really, here.
One
previous meeting between them was on the WTT Youth Star Contender Circuit last year.
2-1.
It was a thrilling match as well. It was a final. Felix winning that one. From 2-0 down, winning in 5.
1-3.
I wonder whether we'll get another thriller here, Neha.
Beautiful receive there from LeBron. I think he's been so strong in that receive game so far. Last 2 points, just absolutely beautiful done. Look at, it seems like it's long, but just light out. Missed contact.
Dictating six, there, one. Right off that receive, which popped up a little bit more than Gao would have liked. It's those fine margins. Talk about a lot at this level.
2
straight
six.
Back at him. Trying to handle the tape there, LeBron.
Yeah, the service itself was brilliantly done. Right off the net cord.
Seven, three.
I mean, it's so beautiful to see how lovely they're moving around the table. So fast on their feet. I mean, at that young age, to be doing that already, so many hours of.
There you go, illustrating your point now, there. I mean, that's fabulous.
So quick.
Just so good over the table.
Yeah.
5-7.
Coming back here, Gal.
I mean, I played my first World Championships when I was 16 years old. And you just sort of have butterflies also in your stomach, right? You're playing at the biggest stage. You're only 16. I'm so proud of both of them, actually, to be putting such a wonderful show so far.
Yeah, level's really high here, actually, in these, you're alluding to, in these first 12 points. In a way here, big stage, round of 64, the main World Championships, there'd be some tension around nerves. They're not showing it.
Yeah, these are fearless teenagers. That was a good placement right on the body. And for a pen holder, it's actually really hard to get the body sorted because the positioning of your racket is such that your elbow needs to do a lot of moving.
9-6.
Reaction was interesting from Gao there. Real approval for it. The quality from LeBron. He can open his shoulders there a bit more now, the French star. Moving to the brink of this opening game. Four game points. Oh, superb.
11,
absolutely superb. Parfait, even. Putting on a show so far here in Durban.
One, low.
Did you have, Neha, in your career, did you have a kind of contemporary, these two already starting to build a rivalry, someone who you came up against in big matches? You know, it was a little bit irritating to you in a nice way. You know, it was trying to really grapple to get the better of them. This is a good matchup.
Yeah, there was this Singaporean, her name is Sim Zena. She's a defender.
Yes.
And we played each other many times, especially at the Commonwealth level as well. And I was honestly not that great against defenders, so I lost to her more than I won. Not a pleasant experience, but well, I love these you know, rivalries, and they go a long way. Of course, we became friends later on. And but yeah, good days and good memories, of course.
Three, two.
You can see how fearless they are, because just the confidence with which they are making each shot is so evident.
Three, two, four.
Also, I absolutely love the energy levels from LeBron, right? So look at how swift he's moving all over the table on his toes.
That's a clever change up there. Just went a little bit deeper, stabbed it into the middle of LeBron. He's got a mistake.
Five, four.
I mean, the level that they are playing at, you just cannot guess that they're still teenagers to be doing it. Look up social media and find Gao Zhongrui on Instagram. You'll see such a cute photograph of him celebrating his birthday. And here they are playing the best, you know, sort of table tennis the world has to offer.
So quick to see the opportunity there, LeBron. Ripping up on the backhand there. Second towel break. Look at the numbers here now on serve, and Gao just struggling a little bit there relatively to LeBron at the moment.
Yeah, no surprise at all. You can see LeBron's just been so dominant so far. Of course, the score tells it clearly.
8-5.
Brilliant from LeBron, because he was getting pushed back away from the table there, and his shot tolerance there, so good, playing with more and more spin, just giving himself time, keeping himself in the rally. Oh, his defense is going up a notch.
Yeah, and so much strength in the legs there. Look at how well he's able to move and cover the table all across. He's always ahead of the ball.
10-6. So. 10-7.
Oh. Wow, where did that come from for the very first time, yeah. I guess.
He's got himself to a third towel break here. He's just coming back at LeBrun here. I mean, that's dismissive, that flick.
So many weapons they're carrying inside, and just can you find the right opportunities to bring that out?
His problem's been behind the service, and it shows again there for Gao. Could be dozens of meetings. Who knows?
Yes. We've seen so many other athletes who are now able to have longer careers, right? We saw Daniel Habison at 36, Chinta Sharad Kamal at 40, and think about it, they're just 16 and 18.
Two, love.
So much table tennis and good table tennis ahead of them.
And just getting started with this rivalry, really, you feel. At the moment, though, it's LeBrun's opponent here, Gao, who is up against it.
1-3.
I mean, rivalry, but I think they have two colors in common. Guess what? After this point.
1-4.
Orange or reddish orange and blue. LeBrun's shoe is orange. And Gao Zhengrui's shoe is blue. And the t-shirt color is the opposite. So lots in common again.
Just in terms of the matchup here, we're seeing here about two and a bit games in, Nehar. Anything standing out for you? I mean, we talked about relative struggle on serve for Gao here to win points behind the serve. Anything else in particular in the matchup for you?
I think it's pretty clear. LeBrun is just moving so much better over the court. Look at how fast his feet are moving, much more agile than what Gao is.
1-7.
It's so stark difference in the speeds at which both of them are playing. Score says it all.
Two-7.
I think he heard me.
It's much more of that, isn't he? A couple of years older, of course.
7-3.
It's just how good this young Frenchman is. Some word, of course, that could end up being better than his brother. His older brother. We'll see on that.
8-3.
Yeah, the Chole comes in. You can see that Gao Zhengrui is inching a bit slightly closer. But I love the fighting spirit from the LeBrun brothers.
3-9.
Yeah, another kind of half shake of the head from Gao here. As another game looks to be slipping away. In and out of the towel break. Just can't really get into this match at the moment. Nathaniel Moulin will be delighted with this from LeBrun.
4-9.
Turns towards his coach there, LeBrun. This is out away from the table for once.
It's a good serve, though. He's got a nicer receive there to hit a good flick, but a bit of a backspin in there. Misjudging.
10-5.
It's caught the corner there from Gao. Saves the first of the game points, but five more here for LeBrun.
Oh, what was that?
I mean... really change the general pattern here. We talked about these two young stars and development in their respective nations. Talked already a lot about the French with Paris 24 in the approaching fast. We're in that cycle now, aren't we? We're going to be with all those events. We were talking about the points up for grabs. But Chinese Taipei as well, this 18-year-old, they look to move forward. Is going to have a huge role to play for his nation.
1-2.
Zhuang Jiayuan isn't going to go on forever, you would think. I mean, he is evergreen, as we call him, but there's going to be some changes.
1-2-all.
It's that evolution, really, that the French have talked about as well. We've seen their youngsters in this, younger players involved here in Durban. Jean-Nicolas Barrelier, the national technical director. A lot of focus falling on the French, building up to the Olympics with their talents. One of them here.
4-2.
Chinese Taipei is also just working brilliantly on building up their pipeline. They now have five players in the top 100 in the world.
Strength in numbers, the approach, development. I mean, you work in development yourself now, developing players. Well, the timeout, do the trick for Gao here.
3-5.
Yeah, and he gets into a lead of 2 points. You can also see now that Jose becoming much more louder and vocal. And I love to always analyze the body languages and the changes in there, right? Just a bit of a frustration on his face as he missed that step around forehand. It seemed like he already read the ball, but unsuccessful there.
6-5.
It's been relentless, though, these attacks. I mean, LeBron's been so smart. Big ball up the middle there. A lot of work on that.
6-0.
Yeah, just subtle changes again. I mean, that receive was slightly longer, deep into the body. And Gao was actually, thinking that maybe it was a shorter one. But then, I mean, I love these strategies that these players execute. You have so much inside you. And if you're able to put that out on the table, that actually is the difference between a top player and, you know, somebody not as good as you are.
6-8.
He's got these big wins, LeBron. Talk a lot about his brother as well, but you think of the semi that he made at the main star contender event in Goa.
Yeah.
Beat Truls Morgard there, Jiang Wujin. I mean, they're not, they're top level wins that he's managed, and he's brought his best largely here.
7-8.
Yeah, he started playing table tennis at the age of 3. You know, talking about talent versus hard work, I think he's a combo, great combo of both.
Gao here just hanging around, though, trailing by one. Big point here. Doesn't take it.
9-7.
LeBron with the services to come here to try and close this in straight games now.
10-7.
Beautiful serve and third ball attack.
Indeed.
Yeah, so confident.
Just hasn't really happened for Gao here. 3 match points, LeBron.
Left, 10-7.
It's a clinical win, that, for Felix LeBron over his contender.